Hey, it's Noctis. Subscribe to Vincent Valentine EX Turk channel.
What's up, guys? Your King and I, Vincent Valentine EX Turk. I don't have to go into work until later this evening, so I get some time to myself pretty much. So I think after this video, I might go straight to bed and sleep in for a little bit, because I don't have to go until this evening due to the fact of it being, you know, several quarters hot and stuff like that. Very steamy outside, so. And, you know. So, I'm probably going to go in a little bit in this evening. So, I'm probably going to head back to bed after I, you know, to get the rest of my sleep after I finish this video. But we got some Final Fantasy news feed on my Facebook, so. I like the stuff that writes its own self. So I don't have to worry about coming up with ideas or theories or anything like that. It just is what it is. So this is by Screen Rant again. Now, just to let you know, there's going to be some trigger warnings. Because there are some triggering content and 15 things to need to be cut from the Final Fantasy VII Remake. And trust me, there are things that will trigger us fans. So, you know, let's just get right into it, since Final Fantasy Peasant has actually covered most of what's going to happen. So let's just go down the list. Genesis is number 15. I love the character Genesis. Already triggered. We're already number one in trigger, but I understand too at the same time, because I mean, he was never in the original, and they're trying to capture the spirit of the original, so they want to get that completely removed. But it's not like you could put some DLC in here, I don't know, but, you know, put some DLC or something like that, make an extra world or something like that, you know, like an extra island, a Colosseum thing, and put him in there, you know, you don't have to have him in the main game. But, you know, I like the Colosseum idea, just like in Final Fantasy XIII, too. But he's not in the original, so I understand. So let's move on. Number 14, the optional status of... Oh, God, sorry. Ads. There's ads in here, too. The optional status of Yuffie and Vincent. The two party members of Final Fantasy VII were entirely optional. You never need to hire Yuffie, and you don't need to awaken the mysterious Vincent Valentine from his slumber. And, you know. And I kind of agree a little bit, you know. I mean, that we shouldn't make them optional. They should be main characters. Okay? The appearance of Final Fantasy VII Remake should be mandatory for the plot of the game, yes. So, the you know, and I agree with that because they're in the compilation, but even though they're removing the compilation, it has confirmed Yuffie and Vincent were involved in the quest to stop Sephiroth, and they were. The reason why Vincent Valentine and Yuffie were in the ending of Final Fantasy VII, and, you know, that one cutscene is because Dirge of Cerberus pretty much put it out there that they were helping civilians evacuate, which I could still see canon. Because it makes sense. They did help a lot. Plus, you know, plus the side quests in the original, like with Yuffie, the Wutai thing makes sense. And Lucretia makes complete sense considering the fact that Lucretia is Sephiroth's true mother. You know. And if this game's going to be about Cloud and Sephiroth like the original, but with some twists and turns to it, then wouldn't it make sense to put, you know, the biological mothers, you know? Vincent is known to be in love with the woman who birthed Sephiroth. Makes him complete. Plus, he's an ex-Turk. Cloud's an ex-soldier, you know? They both have ties to Shinra. Alright, let's keep... So, it makes sense to make them mandatory. Oh! Ow! I'm already triggered! Ooh! I'm already triggered! Woo! Woo! Okay, change the music. It just turned into that. Wutai? Ooh. Oh, don't take out Wu Tai. Having Yuffie and your party member in Final Fantasy VII was most lead annoying side quest. I mean, that side quest was hard. I get it. And, you know, and there's another side quest to get to Leviathan, but come on, don't move Wu Tai. Come on, man. Not Wu Tai. Wu Tai was a good part of the original. And plus, don't you want to make this episodic thing bigger than what it is? Wouldn't it just destroy if you just take out things like that? I mean, you could make things a little longer. I'm just saying, more story, but the Pleasant Planet. Okay, the environmentalism. I don't know. I think that's something they should keep to, because it was about the planet and stuff like that as well. So, why are they putting things that are kind of integral to the game? Shizo. Oh, that's what that thing is. Some of the best boss fights. The fights against Safer Sephiroth, Demon Gate, and Weapon Monsters were forever in memory. So, I mean, I don't know. I guess for this one, you could get rid of it. But, you know, I don't see no reason to get rid of it. You could just, I don't know, put it. I thought these were supposed to be full games. I mean, what does Square Enix don't understand? I mean, not Square Enix, this person that's writing this understand episodic. It was part of the original, so I don't see why I'd take it out if it's part of the original. Just change it up. But if they do remove it, they need to put some more bosses, because Disc 2 and Disc 3, you know, we're getting less and less on bosses. And this is a remake that's episodic. Alright, let's get to number 10, the Supernova Animation. I think instead of getting rid of that, I think we can cut it down to at least a minute, or make it faster. And we could do that with the new graphics and CGI for the Final Fantasy VII Remake. But I think Sephiroth's going to be completely changed too. I'm pretty sure he's going to transform and stuff like that, but I'm pretty sure you have to fight Sephiroth 4 times instead of 3 times, so... Oh, you know, I mean, no, you had to find 3 times instead of 2 times, so, I mean, no, 4 times, because the final battle, but, I'll be quite honest with that. I just think it's cut down to a minute is not, Hojo's Bizarre Adventure. I think they're talking about when, Red 13 was supposed to breed with Eris. And that was kind of shown on Case of Beast. And I don't want to see a bestiality scene, I'll be honest. But I think he should still try to attempt to do that. Because, well, this will show how much insanity Hojo is. Because Hojo is like Joker insanity. If you take out the insanity out of Hojo, then you just pretty much kill that character off. He's known to be insane. I mean, he abused the crap out of Lucretia and just got off to it. You know, so, yeah, no, we gotta keep Hojo insane. No, let's not remove that. Now, maybe let's not put too much into it, but let's make him attempt it and he gets beat like he did in the original game. Alright, place for what? Come on, man, I like the snowboarding game. I'm already triggered. Oh, shit. Oh, I'm triggered. I actually like the mini games. Maybe not put it as part of the main game, but maybe go on extra menu and, you know, or go to Gold Saucer and play this. I don't know. I like the snowboard mini game. And with the graphics and voice acting and all that, come on, man. Come on. No, don't take that out. 7, the Chocobo Breeding Side Quest. Now, you know that's completely optional, by the way. That was actually not a mandatory thing. You know, and so I really don't think you should take it out. I mean, I think maybe to get a gold chocobo, they can make it a shorter time to relieve frustration to people who want to beat the entire game. But it's like, I disagree with number 7. I'm triggered already. Chocobo Breed Side Quest. So, let's see what else we got. The hidden Cinema Secret, Secret Cinema. I disagree with that because, well, we need to put some Zack in here. I mean, now I think instead of him being a mystery, since we know who Zack is, We probably should, you know, put more detail on Zack just a little bit, since we can do this in the remake. Instead of making him a hidden thing, I think it should be part of the actual cinema of Final Fantasy VII Remake. So I disagree and agree. Carry armor. I would personally like to get that boss wiped out because I don't really like him. So that's fine. Why would you take it to Hojo Beach Party? Why? That was one of the integral things. We had to go ask Hojo questions about Sephiroth and Shinra. Oh, no, don't do that. Don't do that. Don't. No. The terrible ending. Okay, maybe you can probably make a much better ending than, you know, just destroy Midgar, but... I'm on the fence for that, so, and the, no, number two, the slap fight, you gotta put the slap fight back in with Tifa and Scarlet. I mean, yeah, it's kind of sexist because, you know, a little bit, but still, it was a good fight. No, don't take that out, don't do that, don't do that, don't take out the slap fight between Tifa and Scarlet. No, don't do that. No! Okay, number one. Kate says Scottish accent. Well, I guess. I guess that can, you know... I guess that could probably be done with that because it's like... I mean, it don't really matter. But I think the... But you gotta have Kate Sith have a different voice than Reeve because Reeve's a spy. So, I'm on the fence to that. I don't completely disagree or agree. But tell me what you think in the comments below if you agree or disagree with this list. I'm gonna try the best to make the video because I'm having some pretty bad rendering problems right now. But I'm gonna head back to bed. So, tell me what you think about this list. I'm gonna link it in the description below. So, may the crystal be with you.
Can't keep my dick in my pants, ayy. My bitch don't love me no more, ayy. She kicked me out of life, bro.
Damn, son, where'd you find this?
Yeah. Ayy. Yeah. Ayy. Yeah. Ayy. Yeah.